Everyone, welcome back to another video of Antwell Plays. Today we're playing Choices Shipwrecked from the VIP section. Even though I don't have VIP, but it's full unlocked. Let's begin. With danger lurking on the island, the need for a safe haven is more vital than before. Yeah, because last chapter we just ran into a panther.
Not a leopard, it's a panther. In case, I said this in the last video, in case y'all missed it. Panther, there are leopards that are black, but we call them panthers, so, black panthers, so, yeah.
Chapter 4, Making Camp. The panther, prowls toward you, growling menacingly. Its movements are completely silent, yellow eyes never leaving you. That is a panther. Oh no. If we run, it'll chase us, and we'll be done for. Yeah. And speaking of running, have you ever, like, the same thing goes with a bear. Like for example, if you try to get, you can't outrun a bear. Sure, they may be big and maybe big, but they can run fast.
Manu carefully unsheathes the diving knife at her thigh, and takes a cautious step forward, placing herself between you and the panther.
Wait. What are you doing?
At your raised voice, the panther roars and takes a swipe in your direction.
Oh, crap. You need me to spell it out for you? I'm going to kill it before it kills us. You can kill it? You could get hurt.
I appreciate the concern, but our options are pretty slim. Your small knife against its claws, you lose every time.
You have a better idea? We need to scare it away. We stand our ground and look big. We can convince it that we're the predators. Whatever you're doing, we need to hurry. We'll tower over it. Pure intimidation.
I think we're big and scary enough. I hope so. The panther pauses momentarily, taken back. A back by your bigger form. And his face twists in anger and bares his teeth at you. Really?
It's not working. I'm not doing that.
We did it. We actually survived.
Told you we didn't have to kill it. Is it really the time for a told you so? It's always time for time when I'm right. You really would have risked your life fighting that thing?
Yes, it's my job to keep you safe. Which includes teaching you how to use this too. You really think that's necessary?
We don't know what else lurks in the jungle, and I can't guarantee I'll always be around to save you.
Let me show you a few things. Teach you how to hold your ground. All right. You raise a good point. I should be better prepared in case we get into danger like that again. Let's find somewhere we'll have more room. This'll do. Have you ever used a knife before? Does a butter knife count? No! Only if you're fighting toast. Well, I fight peanut butter and jelly with a butter knife too, so does that count? No? Okay. Here, let's use this for practice now. A stick. It's like you don't trust me, Canoe. I don't want an accidental flesh wounds today. Careful there. It's not a sword. You're right. It's a twig. Well, let's start practicing with your twig. I could teach you the proper stance or good defensive move. Your choice. Gotta master the basics, right? You want to slightly bend your knees to ease for ease of motion, and you turn your body to make your opponent target as small as possible. Voila! Stand mastered. Not quite. Now? Almost. Visualize your target. Hold your ground, then strike. It's easier with you here. Practice makes perfect. Let's see what you got. More than you bargained for, I bet. A lot of talk, but not much action. I win. Not bad. Didn't know you had it in you. I'm full of surprises. Let's make sure it wasn't just beginner's luck. Miss me. Got you. What's your next move, Doc? And now you're dead. You don't fight fair.
I think we've earned a break now. That move with the panther back there was risky. How'd you know how it worked? To be fair, it was no riskier than hand-to-hand combat with an apex predator. But to answer your question, I spent the last 10 years studying animals and plants in their nature ecosystem. It comes with the territory. So why'd you agree to the training? As much as I could, I don't think I can science my way out of every problem. Plus, I wanted to see you in action, and a feeling you could handle yourself. And what made you think that? Well, you have a tough girl vibe. Yes, I've been in my fair share of scraps. But it's more than that. I can tell you, you're someone who fights for what they want. I haven't really had a reason to fight for a while. Manu? Anyway, hope you don't need them, but at least you're ready if you do. We should probably take some water back to the beach. If this is its watering hole, I wouldn't be surprised if it returns sooner rather than later. Don't you want to test out your new skills, though? Maybe on you if you keep arguing with me. Ouch, you wound me. You roll your eyes, then return your attention to the beakers. Manu changes back into her clothes. That helps you collect as much water as you can. Hold. This should be good enough for now. We need to return to the beach before it gets dark. We've got water, but we still need a fire. We need food, fire, and shelter. You're the survival expert here. What's our priority? Food's tempting, but it's getting dark. We need fire for when the sun goes down. Yeah, having a campfire in the middle of the day feels weird. Roger that. I'll go fetch us some wood. This should do nicely. These rocks might help for a pit. Or pit two. Keep the fire contained. How did this get here? I hope it's not another panther. Manu, can you come here for a bit? What's wrong? Stick too pointy for you? There's something in the trees right over there. Aww. Gotta watch out for bunnies. They'll smother you with cuteness. Huh? I could have sworn I saw a knife over there. I'm holding it right here. Not that one. It was longer. Had an odd shape to it. But maybe I just imagined it.
Or the rabbit hopped off with it.
Now we got everything for the fire pit, except the actual fire.
Well,
we can use, well, there are the ways. With the sun so low, our best bet is to is a friction fire, unless you've got a flint.
Flint and steel,
rub the sticks together. Or lighter. Yeah, let me just pull some out of my back pocket. You're the science guy. It was worth to ask. We'll take turns pulling on the ends of the rope as fast as we can to get the flame started. You realize how friction creates heat and in turn, fire. It's basic physics. Then this should be quick. We just need to work together. We need more speed. Almost there. Quick, we need to blow on it. Fire! We did it! This reminds me of that movie Castaway. Look what I have created! We made a pretty good team, huh? Wow, an actual compliment from Captain Manu. No sarcasm detected. Keep it up and there will be. We're going to need more containers to put food and things in. We've got plenty of large boxes, not to mention in the way of smaller things. These will do nicely. Wow. Never took you for someone who could weave. I'm a woman of many talents. Do you think one will be enough?
Doesn't matter. I don't have time to make more. I need to rig up a hammock before dark. Otherwise, we're sleeping on the ground. I feel bad that you're doing all this work.
I could spare the time to teach you how to weave bowls. Then I can focus on the hammock while you make more. Nick, makeover this entire camp if you want to. We're going to be here a while. Might as well make it comfortable.
Oh.
I'm a faster learner. And so humble, too. So, first you want to lay it out flat in front of you like this. How good are you at braiding? I could use a refresher.
It's pretty easy.
Yes, and work the outside ones to the middle. You'll alternate which side you pull from.
This isn't as difficult as I thought. Never mind. Relax, it takes time to perfect. Of course it does. Okay, what next? For the bowls, you're basically making a giant wraparound braid. Then take the end leaf and use it with the next two leaves to start another braid. You'll do that until you reach the end and tie them off. I can do that. You know where to find me if you have problems. You sure you haven't done this before? It's nothing compared to that hammock. I mean, look at it. I'm not done yet. Make sure to tie those knots tight on the bowls, otherwise they'll never hold. Like this? Great. Now make about 10 more. Huh? Such a taskmaster. What are you doing over there? You said to give the camp a makeover, so that's what I've been doing. Besides, if anyone happens to sail by, they're more likely to notice our camp. It's starting to come together. Still needs a name. Let's call it whatever. Shipwrecked. Sure, why not? Shipwrecked it is. I declare this camp shipwrecked open. As Manu finishes up the hammock, you gather whatever supplies you can to make shipwrecked home. You eye some of your extra supplies in palm fronts. Maybe I can weave my new something from this. Prove how good I am at braiding. She'd probably like a bracelet. You got a small piece of palm. Hey, I have something for you. Close your eyes and hold your hand. Nice try. I guess you don't want your gift then. You made this for me? You lost most of your stuff in the storm. I thought you'd like something new. It's great and unexpected. Thank you. Oh, I think you mean home sweet shipwrecked. You know, I think we did a pretty good job. As night falls, you both collapse around your new fire pit. Relax a little. I'm completely spent. It means you've worked hard today. You both stare into the crackling fire for a few moments. As long as I don't think much about it, this feels just like camping, though haven't I been in years. Where was your favorite place to camp? The beach, the mountains with the cool, crisp air, or the desert. So a desert, the mountains, or a beach? I'm picking a beach. I can fall asleep listening to those waves crashing against the shore anytime. Then you should be feeling right at home here. Except I used to having a few more things. A tent, camp stove, cell phone, privacy for a midnight dip. I could always look away to make that last one happen. Or maybe you could join. What about you? You must have some camping stories. My family didn't have much, so we did a lot of beach camping instead of big volcanoes. My parents had this knack for making no ordinary things feel special, no matter how many times we'd been to that beach. That's so sweet. What kinds of things? We'd make a fire like this and grill pineapples, papayas, bananas, whatever fruit we could find. Sounds like the perfect summer night to me. It's not complete without music, a little music. Nuru retrieves her rescued ukulele from her bag. You did promise to serenade me, and I keep my promises. You're pretty good at this. I'm all right. Nothing to brag about. I never heard something so beautiful before. We should get some rest tomorrow. We'll need to scavenge for food. Go ahead and take the hammock. I was only able to make the one before losing the light. Where are you going to sleep then? I can rough in the sand. Wouldn't be the first time. If you're sure, I guess then. Good night. That's three diamond choices in one video. Usually it's two. Manu, you don't look comfortable. Come join me in the hammock. Fine. This bag's all right as a pillow. Stops being such a tough girl for once, I insist. Besides, I need to keep you warm. It's humid and hot out. But I sleep much better when someone's curled up with me. Right then, twist my arm about it. If you shift your hand like that, watch my throat. So maybe there's not m as much room as I thought. If you want to make this work, we're gonna have to lay on our sides. That is, if you don't mind getting closer. We should definitely do that. I want to be the big spoon. I'm always the big spoon. Yeah, you're always the big spoon when you're sharing a hammock on a deserted island with a woman you just met. Signs point to yes. Sleep well. You too. Morning. Oh. Oops. Shh. Oh, so it wasn't a dream. I thought it was a dream for a second. Okay. We're burning daylight. What's even on today's agenda? How hungry are you, Doc? I could eat. I could eat. That's what I thought. Grab your stuff and follow me. We won't survive without food. Okay, so we're looking for food next chapter, which will be next Monday, people. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys see this. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new to my channel. Share it with your friends. Comment below what you think of the video. If you want to get notified of any video I put up on my channel, hit the notification button next to the subscribe button. I'll see you all in the next video.